tonight. Happy Wednesday. Glad somebody's excited about that. So I have a little calendar on my desk.
You have what?
A little calendar on my desk that has the scriptures. It's not even a translation that I like, but it's still scripture because I have personal favorites. But it's just, I love it because it's a constant reminder. And I don't always even remember to tear the days off, but when I do, I get to read a bunch of scriptures when I remember and when I catch up. And today's scripture just really hit me this morning, and I've been thinking about it all day. And it's from Revelation chapter 21, and I think the Lord wants us to remember that he has promised that he makes all things new. Mm-hmm. And as I've thought about that, I thought, you know, in order for the Lord to bring resurrection life, there has to first be death.
Yes.
And we are so caught up in what we see and what we hear and what we feel and what we experience in this natural world that we forget sometimes the spiritual world and the spiritual truth, the spiritual eternity that we already live in. And I've said it probably a million times, but I think it's the one thing that just makes the most sense to me is things are not as they appear. Things are not as they appear. Never are things as they appear.
Right.
Because the enemy's favorite thing is to make us look and listen to the lies and look at the lies of circumstances, because what we see will pass away.
Yes.
Everything that we can see with our physical eyes will pass away,
yes.
But there are truths that are eternal, that are forever. And so I'm just going to read from the good news. It's the end of the book. We know how it ends. We win. But this is what the Lord, I think, is saying to us tonight. Then I saw a new sky, a new heaven, and a new earth. For the former sky and the former earth had passed away. They vanished. And there no longer existed any sea. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God, all arrayed like a bride, beautiful and adorned for her husband. Then I heard a mighty voice from the throne, and I perceived its distinct words, saying, "See, look with your eyes." How funny.
Mm-hmm.
Different eyes. "See, the abode of God is with men, and he will live, he will encamp, he will tend among them, and they shall be his people, and God shall personally be with them and be their God. God will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be anguish, sorrow, and mourning, nor grief, nor pain any more, for the old conditions and the former order of things have passed away. And he who is seated on the throne said, 'See, I make all things new.' Also he said, 'Record this, for these sayings are faithful, accurate, incorruptible, and trustworthy, and true. They are genuine.' And he further said to me, 'It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I myself will give water without price from the fountain, the springs of the water of life. He who is victorious shall inherit all these things, and I will be God to him, and he shall be my son.'" And I just, it's so hard to let the things in our life die sometimes. It's so hard to let it go and really, truly surrender it, because it means sometimes we do have to watch it die. You know, I can't help but think of my marriage. I had to completely let go. I had given up hope. I had let go and let God. And suddenly something happened I didn't think was possible. You know, and I thought about you a lot, Roberto, today too. You prayed. You believed. There's no difference between our situations. Only in this case, Michael heeded the Lord, and he humbled himself before the Lord, and we prayed for Ariadna. And I still pray that she will. But God has still blessed you. And so God is still going to give you the marriage that you know he promised you, just with a different partner. And so from death came new life.
Yes.
And from death is coming new life in our marriage. And I just, it's so hard to trust the Lord when there's death and destruction all around us. But that's what faith is. That's what trusting the Lord is not believing and knowing to the marrow of our bones that it is finished. It is finished. He has made a way. God has nothing but blessings and love and peace for us, but we have to set aside everything else that would steal it. Because the things that steal our peace, the things that steal our joy, the things that steal our hope are all around us.
Yeah.
The enemy is all around us. And I'm telling you, there is a strong enemy working against this body right now. But I declare in the name of Jesus that when we resist the devil, when we just stand and we look to the Lord and we let go and we stop trying to hold on and we just let go and just say, you know what, God's got it. I don't have to fight this battle. I don't have to do anything other than speak the word and trust the Lord. And life springs. He feeds us from his own hand, from the eternal waters. And I've always said that is what's so special about this place, is that man's hands are not in this place. And that's why I think it's so special. And that's why not everybody can come and they're like, what is going on in this place? This place is different. It's so different. It's so weird. But it looks like chaos. It feels like, you know, anybody can speak. Anybody can speak, because it takes all of us to reveal Christ in every service. And this is a safe place. This is a place where God is welcome, where the Holy Spirit can come and have his way. So he does. And I think that is so precious. And if we can let that leak over into our lives, where we just truly trust him, he will always bless us.
Amen.
Our promises are yea and amen if we will just trust in him. Amen. So I encourage you to let him make things new in your life. Whatever it is that's dying, put it in God's hands and let him bring it to life. He'll either replace it with something better, and he'll plant the seed and he'll bring the people to water it, or he'll bring it back to life with resurrection power, eternal life from the source. In Jesus' name,
amen.
All right, anybody have any prayer requests? Yeah, Roberto.
You know, I'm very thankful for what I have right now. You know, Ariana has come to my mind on occasion recently. But I guess it's because I'm getting closer to my wedding. So that would be like the definitive final nail in that chapter, close it. I'm not saying that I'm not changing my mind, but I'm very thankful for Kelly because she's like the Energizer Bunny, and she has shown me so many things. Like, she knows this city from east to west, north to south, and we've come to places that I never even know existed, and I've been living here for like 6 years. And it's been very... it's been a blessing for me that I get to enjoy and share those things with her, because now I have different interests that I didn't have before. You know, now I'm becoming an urban chicken farmer. And,
I guess Michael's pretty excited.
Yeah. I have 9 chickens in the house, and I'm building things and working with wood and doing all these things, you know, that I'm just creating in my mind, and I'm just reproducing them, and I'm really enjoying it. And I've never worked construction or done any of those things, but I don't know, I really like it. And I think one of the main reasons why I like it is because she gets excited about it. And I just thank God that he brought her into my life, and that we are headed in the direction that we're going, and all the things that are happening are happening. We bought a car on Saturday, because we had to replace her. So we're doing all these things, and he's given us the wisdom to make the right decisions, and I really like the direction that my life is headed. So just thank him, and like you said, just he gave me the partner that I needed to have.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Little birdie told me that there's a birthday in the house.
Woo-hoo.
Mr. Alvin, happy birthday to you. Would you like to praise the Lord tonight?
Yes.
Yeah.
Many of you know Robert Redd. You know, him and his wife used to attend here. And he hasn't so much since, you know, his wife passed away. But he has resources and so forth that he worships the Lord at home. And even though he doesn't have physical eyes to see, take up an offering, just a free will offering, whatever the Lord has, you know, to give to him, which would be a blessing to you and helpful to him, and so if that would be all right, you know, and I could drop it by this evening to him, and because he's, you know, he's done a lot of good and a lot of help to people, and he really has a loving heart, and he's not despondent at this, but it is, you know, kind of pushing the wire for him, so thank you.
Yeah, Mike?
Cindy did talk to him this afternoon also. Him understanding, or Cindy understanding that not a lot of people would hear tonight, that Alvin would be able to do what he could do tonight, and then we'll follow up Sunday to help cap things off, if that's all right with you, Alvin. But we'll do what we can do tonight, and then we'll try, we'll not try, but we'll do it again, do this again Sunday. There is a little bit of edge room to work with. I know he's on a time crunch. But we'll do what we can do tonight, like Alvin asked, and then Sunday we'll continue on. Okay, Alvin?
Wonderful.
All right. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Yeah, Tim.
Yes, I want to thank the Lord. I had an opportunity to work with one of our employees who's been there, DMAC, for a long time. And a lot of times he doesn't really talk deep spiritual things, but just me and him eating lunch, you know, and he is talking about some friends and family that had gone on before him, and he's like 80 years old. And I, you know, I told him, you know, I'm glad I had him. I learned a lot. He started in 1949, so it was a lot that I learned from him. And he just, it was kind of reflective where he said, you know, why am I still here? And just the Lord, you know, letting me to say, you know, God still has a plan for you. You know, and he just kind of took that all in, and I think it's true. It doesn't matter how old you are. I mean, Moses didn't get going until he was 80. You know? So, I just want to thank the Lord, because it was just me and him. Wasn't nobody else in there. And I think he just thought a lot about that. So I just praise the Lord for the opportunity to be able to be there at that moment. So
amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Anybody else tonight?
I had something I didn't tell people about. It's kind of an unexpected blessing. I had a friend I went to school with, Kevin Guzman, that came over and see me one day. So we just stopped and said, "How you doing?" I said, "Well, I've been here like 13 years, and next thing I know, he goes and puts on Facebook what a decent worker I am and how honored Heidi is to have me." Little did I know it was on Facebook, and of those, a lot of people have seen that, and I was so honored. I said, "Man, that just made my day." I said, my manager was like surprised that somebody would notice, and I had been there for a long time, and it just felt good to be recognized. And I think that when you've been at a job 13 years, it's nice to be acknowledged.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Yeah, Mike.
Doug, just lift him up. I know he's not here tonight, but just go pray for him, for Shelly, and for others that aren't here tonight. I know the enemy tries to separate, bring things up, arise, or whatever, but just want people to just go after the heart of God and set our issues to the side and just go after the Lord, because he's the one to help not only resolve those issues, but to bring us to a part of revelation of his love and how he wants to release the love.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, thank you, Lord. Anybody else? All right, well, let's stand and go to the Lord tonight. Heavenly Father, we just come before you tonight in the name of Jesus. We lift up Robert to you tonight, Lord, who is a member of this body, who's worshiped with us, who's fellowshipped with us, who's all spoken words of encouragement and love into our lives. Lord, we ask that you to meet the needs that he has, Lord, through your people. Move in the hearts of your people, Lord, that we are blessed so that we can be a blessing, Lord. We just ask you to meet the needs, Lord. Encourage people to reach out to him, to stay in contact with him, Lord, as he, I'm sure, has problems traveling, Lord. That you bring the blessings to his doorstep, Lord. That you pour out your presence in his home. That you bring encouraging words to over the phone. Lord, let him know that he is loved by all of us and, Lord, by you, most importantly. Heavenly Father, we just ask you to come and meet with us tonight. Fill this house, Lord, with your presence. We come here tonight to worship you, to be in your presence, to be with one another, and to lift up your name, the name above all names. We come together to hear your word, to renew our minds, Lord, to your truth, and to be reminded of how good you are, that you are so good, Lord. Help us to trust you more, Lord. Help us to lay the circumstances of our lives in your hands and to just let go and trust you wholly and completely, Lord, and watch as you bring new life into every area of our lives. We ask you to bless Alvin tonight, our birthday boy. We know that you have a purpose and a plan for every one of his days, Lord, that there be many more birthdays to celebrate. Lord, be with our pastor tonight and Sally. Encourage them, Lord. Encourage them. Continue to give them revelation and wisdom as they lead this body. Let them come back refreshed and renewed, Lord. Lord, and we ask you to draw those in, those who are distracted, those who are hurting, those who are seeking, those who are lost and don't know how to find their way. Bring them across our path and draw them in, Lord, that they might find a safe refuge here in your house, this house of prayer. We thank you for every member of this body. We thank you. We ask you to bless and protect every member, Lord. Encourage us to stir up the gifts within us, Lord, to reveal Christ in the fullness, Lord. And we ask that the age come, Lord, the manifestation of the sons and daughters of God. Let it be now, Lord. Let it be now that the fullness is revealed.
Yes.
Let it be now, Lord, that the fullness of who you are, the fullness of your love and your grace and your mercy, let it be revealed. Open the eyes of the blind, Lord. Open the ears of the deaf. We ask you to break the bonds of religion. We ask you to break the bonds of self-interest. We ask you to break the bonds of self-importance, of pride. Lord, it's not us, but it is you who lives in us, Lord. Let us give you the glory in all things, Lord. As you continue to lead and guide us by your Holy Spirit every moment of every day. Come and meet with us tonight, Lord. Know that you are welcome here, Lord. You are welcome to come and minister to your people. You're welcome to come and speak words of encouragement. You're welcome to come and minister as you will. Lead us and guide us, Lord, to minister to one another as you lead. Thank you, Lord, that this is a safe place where we can come and freely worship and freely bear our needs before you and before each other, Lord. Thank you, Lord, as you bind the brokenhearted tonight. I thank you, Lord, as you encourage the weary, Lord. And I thank you, Lord, that you give boldness to all men to speak truth and light as we light up the darkness and take this city back for your kingdom and for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. This is just a reminder, if you have a cell phone, to silence it or to turn it off. And my personal favorite Friday night of the month,
yes.
Eastern Gate House Prayer. Woo, woo. I don't think I've ever heard you do that, Mike. I'm kind of excited. What are we doing? Whoop, whoop. Well, praise the Lord. That's my favorite, too. As the Lord leads.
The Lord told me last Saturday night, he says, I want you to forget all your agenda and your agendas. I want you to let me reveal the story of my love for you.
Praise the Lord.
Being revealed.
Praise the Lord. There are new songs in this room waiting
yes.
to be birthed. If
yeah.
we will just give them the opportunity.
Yes.
Yeah.
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 Tom Stammen prophesied
mm.
that I need to be setting up a recording studio. You know, he makes it sound like it's a place at home, you know, building a room, da 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 da. It's not this room, it's a recording studio. This,
mm-hmm.
this is, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, praise the Lord. All right, let's speak the word tonight. Will you not revive us again? That your people may rejoice in you. Yes, Lord. I am a believer, and these signs do follow me. In the name of Jesus, I cast out demons. I speak in new tongues. I lay hands on the sick, and they do recover. Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. Therefore, I forbid any sickness or disease to come upon this body. Every disease, germ, and every virus that touches this body dies instantly in the name of Jesus. Every organ, every tissue of this body functions to the perfection to which God created it to function. And I forbid any malfunction in this body in the name of Jesus. I receive the spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of him, the eyes of my understanding being enlightened. And I am not conformed to this world, but am transformed by the renewing of my mind. My mind is renewed by the word of God. The Lord rebukes the devourer for my sake, and no weapon that is formed against my finances will prosper. All obstacles and hindrances to my financial prosperity are now dissolved. The Lord has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant, and Abraham's blessings are mine.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
All right. Eric, can I come take the offering tonight for us?
This will be for our tithes and offerings.
Yes, this will be for the tithes and the offerings, and then afterwards we'll take a second offering for Robert. Yeah.
So much about our covenant with you that you kept
yes.
it with yourself.
Yes.
And you truly said,
yes.
It's nothing that we've done, what you've done,
mm-hmm.
and that you've made us partakers
yes.
in all these great things that you've planned. Thank you, Lord, that you kept us in remembrance even before we were born.
Yes.
That's how much you love us. Just
yes.
give us that revelation of your love
mm-hmm.
as we can open our hearts
yes.
and see you, hear you, praise you, Father.
Yes.
The new songs could be birthed in this place.
Yes, Lord.
Just a new chapter of worship, of praise could start, Father.
Glory.
To the glory of Jesus for his heart. Pray that you would bless our finances as you promised. We know we're just,
yes.
our eyes are looking to see him.
Mm-hmm.
Our hands are out, ready to receive, Abba. Thank you so much, Jesus.
Jesus, thank you.
Hallelujah.
The house.
do. We are here, Father, to celebrate your faithfulness. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus, for everything that you do for us. Amen. All right. You may be seated. Thank you, worship team, minus myself. That sounds pretentious. I hope everybody's doing well tonight. You know, for a second there, I forgot that I was doing this tonight. Like 5 minutes ago, I was standing there, and suddenly it kicked in again. Oh, wait, I'm actually speaking. But it's all good, it's all good. So hopefully what I'm going to talk to you tonight makes sense. As always, can you hear me? Is that better? A little louder?
Mucho good.
Is that good?
Mucho better.
Okay. You know, usually when I speak here, the things that I say make sense in my mind. So I don't know if it'll make sense in yours. But I don't know. Kelly says that she cannot handle it. I think it stresses her out. So, yeah. She's like, when you're with me, think in one direction. Anyway, so last week, I don't know if for those that were here, you know, I talk about some of the things that I felt the Lord was telling me that are part of what our identity is in Christ. You know, who He says that we are in Him. So I talked about how we are created. You know, God brought us into existence, and He created us in His image. I also talked about how we are chosen. You know, He selected us to carry out His word and to share it with the world. I also talked about how we are His children. You know, we become His children just by simply believing in Him.
Yes.
You know? And I also talked about how we are redeemed. So what I want to talk to you today is how you can find in the scriptures what you need to do when you're waiting for something. After I gave my message last week, I started asking God, what do you want me to talk about next? And I wasn't hearing anything until today. And I think the reason for that is because of what Suzanne shared when she opened. Because some of the things that I'm going to say, she already touched on in her opening message. So when you are waiting for something, you can look at this from two different perspectives. And this is going to be, both perspectives are from a Christian standpoint. But one of those is from the perspective of when you are a new born-again Christian. And the other one is from the perspective of you being a current believer that is going through a trial of some sort. So, bless you. The Bible says that when we accept we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior for the first time. You know, Mike, if you can go to Romans chapter 10, verses 9 and 10. It says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth that the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So we uttered those words, and we're saved. It says in verse 13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So you uttered the words that Jesus is Lord. And then without any doubt in your heart, you know that God raised him from the dead, and you're saved. but you also call upon his name. It's when you do that that your new transformation begins. You know, we start this process in which our lives are going to be turned upside down, because believe me, it was for me. Everything as you know it is going to be changed or challenged, because it was for me. I don't know if you remember, I've shared this a couple of times. One of the hardest things for me was to believe the creation, because I am a biologist and I understand the concept of evolution. So I had a hard time wrapping in my the concept of the creation in my mind, because my flesh was fighting my spirit. No, the correct thing is what happens based on what Darwin explained. It's not what it says in here, that the world was created in 6 days. Well, I chose to believe this.
Amen.
And I know that's the truth.
Right.
Yes.
Because what we see in this world is not the absolute truth. It's the perception of our flesh,
that's
of what's
right.
happening around us. And I came to understand that at some point. And, you know, as I continued my path as a Christian and continued my growth, I came to that realization. So now, if we truly want to be changed, that's what's going to happen. You know, your life is going to be turned upside down. Everything that you know or thought is going to be challenged, because when you look at the Word of God and when you look at what is said in the world, there's a lot of conflict, because sometimes those things don't match. And then that's where your struggle is, you know. What am I going to believe? What God says or what the world is saying? So we begin this journey of self-discovery as new creatures in Christ. And it can feel like a little bit of an overload. And that's kind of what happened to me. You know, I wanted to know more about God. I wanted to know more about his word. I wanted to know who he is, what he has done, what he's going to do.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're in that rush at the beginning. I mean, we can continue to carry that rush for the rest of our lives, because I've seen that here. And I have it still. So there are so many things that, as you continue your path, you want to happen, and you want to know. So when I was going through this, I wanted all of those things to happen. Lord, I want to know more about you. I want to know who you are. I wanted you to give me all the revelation that you can give me. But he has a way of doing things, and it's for our own good. Because our minds are limited based on our human nature. As that was happening, parallel to that, I was asking him to do certain things for me, like you were talking about. My previous marriage was falling apart, and I was asking God to restore it and to bring her back into my life. So, and here I'm starting my growth. And in here, I'm asking him to do something for me. And the more I know, the more I ask. And the more I know, the more I ask, but the more anxious I get. So as I'm learning those things, I'm also expecting things to happen that are based on the things that I'm learning.
Right.
So those two were hand in hand. That's why as I learn, I ask. As I learn, I ask. And I was expecting. And it was very overwhelming, not in a bad way, but as I said, you get anxious. So that's a good thing in these circumstances, because this teaches you patience.
Yes.
And that's what I want to focus on tonight, patience. So one of the first things that I learned was to trust. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. So as I said already, my mind knows some things, but the Lord is revealing some things to me, and they're clashing. So what do I do? Well, I'm going to trust him, and I'm not going to lean on what my mind already knows, because I need to discover what is the truth. So as I was going, you know, you start getting anxious. But in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, it says, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." In another translation, it says, "Don't be anxious." Mm-hmm. Well, that's easy to say, but it's hard to do. As you go, in due time, we learn not to be anxious anymore. And the next verse tells what happens when we don't get anxious. Verse 7 says, "And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus."
Mm-hmm.
You feel peace.
Yes.
And that's a good thing. So all of this is something that is continuous. It happens over and over every day. To some extent, sometimes it seems like it's this gigantic trial, and sometimes it's just this little thing.
Right.
But it's something that it keeps happening. And as we go through these processes over and over, something else is happening that is also part of God's plan for our lives. And that is that we develop patience.
Mm-hmm.
So Romans chapter 5, verses 3 and 4. "And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope." So as we go through these trials, and we continue to study God's word, we learn that we shouldn't be anxious, but continue to pray, continue to be thankful, because that peace is going to come to us.
Mm-hmm.
And when we have that peace, we become patient. When we're patient, we have experience, and because of that experience, our hope increases.
Yes.
Amen.
Romans chapter 8, verse 25. "But if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it." So all of these things that are happening, all these things that we're asking for, are things on the unseen. It's really easy to hope for something that you have seen, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And what's the point of that? I mean, that's not true hope. Because
right.
If they tell you, "I'm going to bring you a loaf of bread," and you know what a loaf of bread looks like, and you have had a loaf of bread before, so
yeah.
It's easy to have
sure.
hope that they're going to bring you a loaf of bread because you're hungry. But when God tells you, "I'm going to give you this,"
yeah.
that thing that he's telling you that he's going to give you, you've never seen it before.
Right.
And it's really hard to wait for that. But through this patience that we develop, that hope grows, and then it's easier for us to wait for those things.
Yeah.
That's the beauty of it all. We learn to trust God.
Yes.
We go to a trial, and we don't become anxious. When we're not anxious, the peace of God will keep us. And because of this, we wait for what we've been told or promised with patience.
Yes.
Amen.
Now this is a good thing, because not only it helps us, it also helps us help others.
Sure.
Yes.
In the Bible it talks about we should be there for one another, we should pray for one another, you know, we should extend our hand to our neighbor and all those things, because that's how Jesus was, you know. He he loved everybody and he cared for everybody. And he said, do as I say. You know, do what you see me do, because I only do the things that I've seen my father do.
Exactly.
So sometimes, though, our flesh might try to steer us away from this. If we're waiting for something in particular, and then we see someone else receiving the thing that we've been waiting for.
Right.
It's really funny because you can be the most planted person on the ground. You know, you can be planted like the most obnoxious weed in your garden that you cannot, for as much as you try, can pull it out. It continues to stay there. And then you're waiting for that thing, someone else that you know, that you're also been praying for or hoping for something for them and asking God for that, then all of a sudden happens for them before it happens to you.
Yeah.
And what happens? Flesh kicks in.
Uh-huh.
And then you're like, you know, this little green monster starts popping from behind you.
Uh-huh.
And saying things to you in your ear. But this is what the Bible says about that. Psalm 37, verses 7 through 9. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil. For evildoers shall be cut off, but those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. Rest.
Yes.
Wait patiently for him.
Mm-hmm.
See the pattern?
Yep.
Why would we inherit the earth? It says there, excuse me, in verse 9, that those that wait upon him shall inherit it. Well, because when we become children of God, we are now fellow heirs with Abraham, and we can expect all the promises of Abraham to be ours.
Yep.
So you continue to wait and be patient. Sometimes it can wear off. But then this is what Hebrews 10 says about that, verses 35 and 36. Cast not away, therefore, your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, that after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise.
Lord. Thank you, Lord.
When we have patience, we do the will of God. What's the will of God? Rest in him.
Mm-hmm.
What does he say? Come to me, all you who are heavy burdened, and I will give you rest. We rest in him. We let him operate in our lives, whatever situation that is going on, and we can expect to receive what was promised.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
So this is the last scripture that I want to read. And I think it summarizes everything that I have talked about. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 12 through 16. I'm going to read it from the English Standard Translation, even though that's the King James, but it says, I thank him who has given me strength, Christ Jesus our Lord, because he judged me faithful, appointing me to his service. Though formerly I was a blasphemer, persecutor, an insolent opponent, but I received mercy because I had acted ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord overflowed for me with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. The saying is trustworthy and deserving of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. But I received mercy for this reason, that in me, as the foremost, Jesus Christ might display his perfect patience as an example to those who were to believe in him for eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
Be patient, be still, wait on the Lord. Receive his mercy, his grace, for he will display his perfect patience through you to be an example for those that come through your path that are looking for him and want to believe.
Yes.
And that is my message for you tonight. You're dismissed.